Hi friends. If you want to check out my current CHIKUHODO brushes, the ones that I love and the collection that I continue on growing, then please keep on watching. Hi, my name is Alicia. If it's your first time here, thank you so much for clicking on my video. And if you are returning, well, thank you for visiting me again. Kinky Sweat stands for my kinky hair and sweat life. I am a fitness professional who loves things all movement and beauty. If you want to check out what I do in between the makeup, skin, over to my Instagram. Many of you have requested that I go over my current CHIKUHODO brushes, which aren't a lot, but they are my standout favorites. And mostly because they are very expensive. To get the lowdown on them, are they worth the money? What do you use them for? What's the big deal? So here are my current CHIKUHODO brushes, as well as the coveted, well-loved P8 powder brush. Not a whole lot. I still have my eye on that Fox set, and I still want the Z1. She is still on my list. And thank you guys for letting me know about fudebeauty.com. They do sell them less than how they sell them on Beautylish. So my cart's full. I'm logged into my account, it's full, it's just I gotta pull the trigger, but what's going on right now in the world, I'm tightening the budget a little bit because that could be really important money for, like, you know, not working because of what's going on. The first brush I want to show is the CHIKUHODO Makiyei number 2. Now, if you see this beautifully painted handle, the detail on the wood is phenomenal, and it just makes it a work of art. Even so much, I don't even want to use this brush sometime. But I better, because it's expensive. Before I move into the details of the individual brushes, if you are just tuning in to one of my videos, if you don't quite know the difference between natural hair brushes and synthetic ones, the discourse can be dissected in several ways, right? People are like, natural fibers are a huge no because of moral reasons, and people who are still cruelty-free insist on buying Japanese made brushes because the way they treat the animals in terms of acquiring the hair is actually quite humane, more so than what we might think. And I was speaking to Michelle Wong about this, and her trip to Japan kind of solidified her assumptions in that everything the Japanese do is just with great detail and great care. And we could only imagine that they apply that intention to how they treat these animals in regards to making brushes. That's why a lot of times when a lot of these brushes go out of stock, it takes a long time because they ain't gonna overbrush the animals, okay? If the animals don't have any more hair to give, they don't got any more hair to give, and they just have to wait until the next round or however they do it. Now, some people still don't believe that story. They don't feel it's legit. They're like, I don't care if these animals are coddled and have their own canopy bed. As long as the natural fibers are used, I still consider it to not be cruelty-free. And that's all good, right? We could discuss further down below. Of course, I always encourage that we remain respectful in those exchanges. The reason why the Japanese-made brushes are particularly more expensive than natural hair fibers you find like in a Morphe brush, it's because those fibers are laser cut into the shape the brush is in, whereas these brushes, their fibers are hand bundled to the shape, and depending on how they're bundled will determine the brush's function in terms of density, brush hair length. Everything about the setup is going to determine what place it will have in your makeup routine. And you have different grades of natural hair, right? This is blue squirrel. You have goat hair, dyed and undyed. Blue squirrel, or I think it's either blue or gray, it's the same, I think, depending on the translation. Don't quote me on that. Squirrel is usually used for powder, right? And the reason why squirrel is recommended for powder application because the distribution of the product is so feather light and it buffs the product beautifully into the skin, and it makes you a powder user if you haven't before, especially if you're a drier skin type and you find like no matter what powder it is, even if it's an hourglass powder that claims to be skin-like in finish, and you're like, oh, this sun, and you feel no matter how you apply it, it still looks heavy on the skin. If you are heavy-handed with blush and you need that light flush of color that applies evenly, squirrel hair. And also natural fibers, because they're not cut, the ends are kept intact, right? You might not be able to see it with your eye, but microscopically, the ends of the natural hair fiber are blunt when they're laser cut, as opposed to the natural point of it being intact. That's what lends a nice soft feel on the face, no scratchiness, no roughness. And it really does make a difference. And you can just see how the bristles move so elegantly. And it's just like, every time I try to speak about these brushes, I get so tongue-tied because the experience, friends, the experience. And you know, if you have one of these brushes, you know what I'm saying. Furthermore, natural hair fibers have the cuticles intact, right? Because it's a natural hair. So the powder pigments get into the cuticle, and that's what allows for more even distribution of product. I'm sure before, maybe you've applied blush, bronzer, contour, and it looks muddy with a synthetic brush or maybe a very cheap natural hair brush. No matter what brush you use, if it's a Japanese brush, no matter the size, the design, what have you, it's gonna look flawlessly diffused, buff, skin-like, airbrushed, poreless, whatever all those positive words are for to describe your makeup finish, it's there. Now, what was I saying? Makiye 2. Like I said, the handle is just beautifully designed. And this brush in particular, I use to set my foundation or to buff after I've applied all my cheek products. You could also use this to apply a light application of bronzer, even a light wash of blush, I would say. If you're using a very light color and you just still want some flush on the cheeks, you could very much well use this brush. And because the ferrule is oval, it has some pinched, slightly tapered, but it's just so beautiful and intuitive to use, as all these brushes are. Now, this is no longer available, and I don't want to create FOMO, but the most recent Lunar New Year brush, the CHIKUHODO and Beautylish collaboration, this is the Year of the Rat brush. And in comparison to the Makiye 2, the Year of the Rat brush is slightly smaller. They both have a oval ferrule and an oval ferrule grammar. So because of the brush size, this might be more appropriate for a more concentrated application of bronzer, or maybe you're more comfortable using a brush head of this size, so it will not spread if you're using a bigger brush like the Makiye 2. Again, loose powder application, buffing of products. You could even, I mean, it's a big brush to use for under eye application, powder application, but why not? Why not indeed? Next up from the Z series. The Z series is CHIKUHODO's, one of their premium lines. They have different lines within the CHIKUHODO brand, and Z line is like top notch luxury. I mean, the quality, friends. This is Z9. Now, I still have my eye on the Z1. Z1 is coming soon. In comparison to Makiye 2, I would say Makiye 2 is a little more dense, and this Z9 is a little more feather light. But again, just the flow and slide of these bristles, and you can just see on the face. And this is particularly important if you are not successful in applying powder products, layering them. When you try to do so, they look layered. They look like you have too much makeup on. It just does not look seamless at all. It sits on top of each other. When you use a squirrel hair brush, and more specifically any brush from the Z series, it just distributes the product in such an even fashion that it makes a makeup novice confident in their own makeup application. If they've been traumatized before and they find that they can never successfully apply bronzer or any type of cheek product without it looking like they did their makeup and not a professional, this will make you look like you applied like a professional. No matter your skill level, it just helps with that. And I find that all my powder products have just been applying beautifully, and people are amazed at how much makeup I have on. They are amazed the fact that my skin looks like itself. It doesn't look heavy, it doesn't look textured. The powder brush in particular for Z9, again, probably more successful than the Makiye 2 for bronzer applications, since it is slightly smaller, still tapered, but I feel it just fits beautifully into the hollows of your cheeks. Dare I say, you could do a very light wash of highlight if you like on the cheekbones. It'll be very a wider application. So perhaps a powder that's not like a traditional highlighter, maybe a matte powder instead, or something with a little radiance, some luminosity, but not in an actual shimmer powder. And blush, why not? Go ahead with that. Now, my favorite so far, if it's not the Z9 from that series, it is most definitely the Z8. I mentioned this in my Beautylish gift card event video last year. I might have featured this in some Get Ready With Me's, maybe a favorite video. The Z8 is just one of the most versatile shaped brushes. You could use loose powder, buffing, blush, contour, bronzer, highlight, anything. Anything. And the brush head is just so beautifully smooth and well designed. I think it's particularly ideal for bronzer application because the brush head is not super big like the Z9, but I feel if you like a really nice wash of bronzer, you'll use a bigger brush head like the Z9. But if you want something more concentrated, the Z8 will be ideal. This is just a standout shape. And when you look at both of them together, I mean, just the brushes themselves are gorgeous. I'm picking up the wrong one. Just the brushes themselves are gorgeous. Let me get you another size comparison because I picked up the Maquillage 2 by accident. I don't know what to say. These are so phenomenal. Phenomenal. I go back and forth with which ones I use. I keep some at home. I bring some to travel with me. The ZA I use for travel because since it is smaller, it's going to take up less space in my brush holder, brush book, brush, what's the word I'm looking for? Case, brush roll. This takes up less space in my brush roll, but I could do so many tasks with it that I don't need to pack. Ooh, that was close. I'll need to pack other brushes for like brush, contour, and bronzer. I just have my little CHIKUHODO. I don't know where it is right now. Here it is. I keep mixing them up. Excuse me. My HAKUHODO brush towel, when I'm moving between products, I just lightly sweep and then I move on to the next product. This is the CHIKUHODO GSN02. I use this for liquid foundation, and on the CHIKUHODO website, it does indicate what mediums you can use each brush for, and it does specify cream, powder, or liquid. I like to punch in my liquid foundation with this brush. You could also use this for powder, which it says is for powder, but I love the gold ferrule and the pearl finish wood handle. This is a beautifully designed brush, and it's unlike anything I have. Like, it's so round. This is a circle ferrule, completely round ferrule, and the brush length I feel is unique. How it's shaped is unique. I can't. One of my most favorite, I'm so sorry, she is so dirty. This is the CHIKUHODO T4. This is from their T series, which is one of their other premium lines in the CHIKUHODO brand. This has a matte black finish to the handle. This brush, this is undyed goat hair, so this technically can be used with powder and with liquid and cream and or cream. It's more flat topped rather than tapered, but there is a slight taper to it if you can see it. So it's not completely flat like the Sonia G Face 1, like that's completely flat top. This has a little taper to it, but it's domed. Perfect for bronzer. It just fits right there. Blush too, I feel this will dispense a lot more blush than this brush, for instance. I could go back to the Z8. This is going to be a lighter wash of color because this is squirrel, this is goat. Goat hair tends to pick up a little more product than squirrel hair. So people who tend to be heavy-handed or they feel they look a little too clownish, they gravitate towards the squirrel hair. Or maybe you use this to buff and use the goat hair to apply your cheek products. I freaking love this brush. I feel this is multi-purpose as well. Loose powder application, buffing. I think this is actually, it's a little dense for buffing, but you can get away with it because it's still very lightweight and not too dense. But if you like a little more blush and bronze, use the T4. Now, before we get into the smaller brushes, I can't go forward without talking about this P8 again. Now, I gushed over this in my February faves video. It comes with its own holder. So it has its own home. This is like a rare length of squirrel hair, and the fluff of this brush, I can't even, like, I'm undeserving of this brush. It is a work of art, and I feel guilty using it. I do. Despite the amount of money I spent on this freaking brush, I use it because I definitely want to get my investments worth. But man, oh man, I mean, this, listen, when everything has been applied and I'm just putting on that finishing buff, this brush is just... If you want your powders to look like skin, okay, come here, listen to me. If you want your skin to look so flawless, it looks fake, use that PA. Listen, if it's not in your budget, don't get it. Please don't spend that amount of money on a brush. I would say you could get that from the Z9. You could even get that from the Makiye 2. The PA is just next level sensation and feel. It's really an indulging experience. But listen, you'll have the brush for the rest of your life. Ain't going nowhere. Now for smaller brushes, this is really unique. You know, I bought this because I saw it and I was just so intrigued by the shape. This is the Z Series contour brush. And I mean, look at how small this is. Definitely more tabletop and finish. You could just punch in a contour powder, but because of the squirrel hair, it's going to diffuse it very nicely and on its own, basically. So if you want more of a precise application of contour powder, definitely use this brush. The T6 from the T series. I love this size brush. It's like a mini face brush and a very big eyeshadow brush. So if you're one to use one and done colors on your eyes, maybe it's a matte, you pull that across the lid and then turn it on its side to buff the color through your crease. This brush is phenomenal. You could also lightly tap powder under the eyes if you're not a powder person for under eyes and you need something like a small brush, but bigger than an eyeshadow brush, a typical one. Let's say if I picked up, I wanted to pick up, no. My Wayne number 3 from his Annie 2, right? Sometimes Wayne will use this to set under the eyes, but if you want something a little bigger, this one right here. Highlight as well, down the bridge of the nose. You could even use this to apply concealer. Some people like to use brushes to apply concealer. Since this is undyed goat hair, you could very much use that for that application. I like to do that sometimes if I'm going very light on the concealer one day, instead of using a denser pack brush. Let's say if I didn't want to use my Zoeva face shape 110 or even my hourglass brush or even my Pat McGrath Labs concealer brush. This is just more lightweight in application. It's not densely packed, so it's not going to lay on as much product. Next brush, we got two more. This is the T7. The T7 is like packer blender in one. It's a lot smaller than the T6. As you can see, it's like the baby version of the T6. And if you want something smaller to apply a more precise application of color on your lid, this is ideal for lower lash line blurring and blending and just hazing out, also in a corner. So I would consider this brush very much multifunctional in regards to the eyes, that it's not so densely packed that you can't blend with it, but it's not so fluffy that you can't pack on with it either. And the last brush I wanted to present out of my CHIKUHODO brushes is the, I think this is the Z11, the blend brush. This is squirrel hair. And if you are at the end of your eye makeup routine and you just need to blur out the edges in a way that looks diffuse, flawless, airbrush, and smooth, I also rely on this brush if you're looking for a very light eye look that day and you just need to lightly buff in some color that's more like a light wash of color instead of concentrated like what I did today. Use the Z11 and it's just so foolproof. The bristles move the pigment effortlessly across the skin. And especially, listen up. If you have mature lids or the lids move very easily, that's why it is so imperative that you use a natural hairbrush. There are synthetic brushes that are soft out there. I have not used them, so let me know down below if they are. But they tend to move the lid. Natural hair brushes that are hand bundled, okay, not machine made. They move better across the skin, and that will enable the pigment to glide smoothly, not move the skin, so you get an even distribution of color. This is so important. I can't even tell you. I tell people who have more mature lids or they don't wear eyeshadow because they feel that it never looks blended, it doesn't look smooth, it looks skipped, it looks patchy. Especially if you're not looking to use cream products. Let's say if you wanted to use a cream shadow, then I would recommend an undyed goat hair brush like the T7, right? But if you're just using powders, just use a squirreled hair brush. This freaking brush, man, it's so soft, will not move your skin, will just evenly distribute the powder on your eyes, and it will look blurred. That's it for now. I know this was very quick because I'm a little bit on the time schedule, but I wanted to present all my current CHIKUHODO brushes. If you are thinking about buying them, if you didn't want to take the plunge, I mean, these are phenomenal. And the reason why I didn't do a demo in this video is because I used these several times in other videos. So if you wanted to catch those, I will try to find the ones that I did use them on and I will link them down below. But if you also want a demo, I'll just do a separate video demoing each brush. But let me know, friends, if you picked up any CHIKUHODO brushes, what your favorites are. And until then, that is all right. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope this video helped. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and maybe consider subscribing to my channel. And until then, I'll see you on here again with another tutorial, review, CHIKUHODO brush video, favs, or Friday night chit chat. Take care, and I'll see you again soon.